New Mexico, land of the air balloon. Wait, no, that's not right. New Mexico, land of chili. Wait, no, that's not right either. Okay, I got it, I got it. New Mexico, land of enchantment. You want to know why it's called land of enchantment? You got mountains, sunsets, and yes, of course, you do have chili. Albuquerque, New Mexico is where my coaching journey started. Española, New Mexico is where it got real spicy and got a little bit more interesting. Coach Lackey is what they called me, and in the gym is where you could find me. Coaching at a new level with a great team and a great head coach was a super exciting experience for me. But where there was X's and O's, there was not Coach Lackey. I was not an X's and O's person. My only thing that I wanted to do was figure out how to simplify the game and how to make these players better. So that's what I focused on. I was mostly film and in the gym. Film and in the gym. This is where I can say I grew the most as a player development coach. And I was lucky to have a head coach that allowed me to do my own thing. He actually believed more in my ability to make these players better than I actually believed at the time. Now, I knew I was pretty good, but after my first year being a college coach, I knew just how good I was. For the first time, I started to see great turnaround times, where faces like this soon became smiles in a short period of time. Because when you have kids that don't necessarily understand the game as a whole, don't understand body positioning, doesn't understand angles, doesn't understand speed changes, whether you're in the post or if you're a guard, all of these things matter. And once I saw that they can pick up on these things quickly, once explained the right way, oh yeah, it was game time then. And I got more confidence. It wasn't just the players. I became a better trainer, as well as a better coach. And a lot of times, training is just about instilling confidence. This kid worked out for 3 months to get a better shot. And her shot was wet after that.
Good shot.
Before, she had no confidence in shooting, and her shot wasn't that great. But she came and got me every day, and we put in the work.
Down. Ooh, that's a good one. Down. Good.
I don't like to teach a bunch of different moves. I like to teach angles, strategies, how to move, when to move, and how to use your body. That's it. And get a bucket. I became a better trainer because I learned what to keep and what to throw away. If the player understands situations, understands what moves, how to move, and what to do in those situations, then the rest is up to them. All you have to do is provide them with an understanding and watch them ball out.
What's up, y'all? It's Coach Joe, if you didn't already know. So, take control of your game is not just a show, but we also have a workout program combined with it. It's called our TCYG PACK, all right? It has a part one and a part two, full of workouts and movements that will automatically, if you work on it just a little bit, it will automatically make a noticeable difference that everyone can see, including yourself. Especially with your footwork and your ball handling. Not only that, but we provide you with daily workouts that take maybe 10 to 15 minutes to complete, but will automatically make a noticeable difference as long as you're willing to do it and put in that work every day. I've also created a template for you to follow when it comes to the politics in sports. Okay, I get that not everybody vibes with their coach. I get that not everybody has that trust factor between themselves and their coaching staff. So I provided a way for you guys to close that gap. All right, and if at some point you cannot close that gap, all right? And you and your coach just may not be clicking. There are other ways to get your player on the court, all right? And I'm giving you this. I'm giving you this. It is just a special part of the program. And not only that, okay, I'm also going to hook you guys up with some on the court situations, all right? The most important things that you need to know when you're on the court, because the reason why you get benched is because you're not necessarily doing the right things when you're on the court, when you're in those situations. So I'm giving you the things that you need to look out for and the movements that need to be practiced in order to make the right reads and understand the situations that you're in. So grab your TCYG pack today.
So I left the college after 2 years because I realized this is not what I want to do. I am a trainer, so I need to be in spaces where I can learn more about what it is that I do and be around more people who do the same.
All over the country, the world, and there's no ego in this. I don't think I've had or seen one interaction, had one interaction with any ego, right? I'm like, yo, it's all like, yo, this dude's actually pretty cool. This guy's no ego. But when we're on social media, it's like, nah, good job. So my challenge to you guys and to myself is take that same feeling that you get right now, take that same dynamic that you have that we've experienced this weekend, and take that with you over the course of this year, right? Learn from everyone. Not only are amazing speakers, but everyone in here has learned something from another attendee. We've built relationships, we've networked. Continue to do that, because ultimately, that's the only way that our industry is going to grow. And with the industry growing, that's how we grow, right?
Shout out to Coleman with By Any Means Basketball for the first player development conference in Miami, Florida. It was great. They had some of the biggest names in basketball development. Now, we were in a room surrounded by people with like minds who wanted to learn more and who just wanted to add more to the game, as well as give the kids that we work out with every day more knowledge and more value. And for the first time, I felt incredibly comfortable. I also gained a new mentor out of Drew Hanlon, which is the top NBA trainer ever. For the first time, I truly learned what it meant to be a student of the game.
So all I want you to do is do this with me. You're gonna go between your legs, and I want you to take like a half of a breath, like a. Then I want you guys to drop back. Nope, not ball on cross, just right here. I want you to drop back, and then I want the whole body to push forward and flinch forward. Let me try that. Here we go. Keep your feet. Feet don't move. Feet don't move.
Pound before, no pound.
It's just a between and then a fake. A between. And then a fake. Don't move your feet, though. Yep. Boom. Good. So do it again. Watch this real quick. Let me see that ball real quick. Watch the three steps. Number one, between. Number two, drop. Number three, flinch. Drop, flinch. Drop, flinch. Drop backwards, flinch forward. So walk through. We're just going to do this together, just like I would do with you. So hold up real quick. Start with the ball in your left hand. Between. Flinch forward. That's good. That's what we want. Now do it again. So real quick, because right when we did it, that's okay. What you did was you immediately stayed forward. I need the drop, rock back and then forward. Rock back and then forward. Yep. That was good. Right there is perfect. What he's doing is perfect right there. Let's see what you got. Do it. You're not rocking back though. Here's why. Let me tell you the little detail why this matters. If you study any good driver, anyone, every single time when they drive, they load before they go. Every single one. You're never gonna have a driver that just goes like this unless it's an exchange where you'll see like Luca and them where they'll be high and they immediately drop low. You know, Dame Lillard does that as well.
The amount of knowledge that you can gain by just putting yourself in a room with people who know more than you, with people who do what you want to do, is incredible. Not only that, but the relationships that you can build just by being in a room full of people with the same mind and the same vision is also a great opportunity. Once you figure out what it is you want to do, what it is that you love, and once you gain access to that knowledge, it's like a drug. You're going to want more of it. I also got to have a really dope conversation with somebody I look up to Devin Williams, who also has a crazy YouTube series and is pretty much the inspiration for this one right here.
Stand right here, box, everybody's in here, but now I kind of offset that if I move over here and I have other options, I'm just moving over, but the name of the game at half court set is cradle whip. Almost space for whip. Space for whip. I've been saying it, what's the hardest thing to stop in a half court set? We're trying to create a closeout, right? At the end of the day, we're trying to create a closeout. What do we work on, or what should we work on the most when we're training? Nowadays, especially. Spot up shooting, right? So if I can create a situation where you can spot up shooting, especially the three-pointer, that's what we're trying to create, right? Attack point, right? Access point. So I get to the elbow, this elbow is the access point. This side's the access point. And the opposite, same thing. That elbow and that's your corner right there. These are access points. Now, I'm pulling off the screens or I'm going off the jump or whatever. Say, God's guarding me.
Absolutely.
I'm coming off, I'm trying to get. I don't want to ever be too close to these. I'm trying to really like get into some shit now, but I got to leave in a second. But I'm trying to get to this spot. Right. I want to start looking that way. I want to start looking this way. Why? That's one thing, but I'm trying to hold the defense. With my eyes. If I look that way, I know where I'm going. Right? But I get to this point. Now this opens up. Now he's behind me. I create a 2-on-1. I'm at an advantage. Right? No matter how you think about it, if you get to your access points and work out of these points right here, you have an advantage. Chris Paul, the whole season he was getting right around here, he's dragging bigs out, or he's going through, holding, looking this way. Oh, thank you. Just get to his access point. All right, so these are the main things I learned from big time for Earl Watson. Right? Just get into the access point, because once you get there, you unlock everything. Whether it be a shot, a floater, a pocket pass, or a lift. Low-key from ISO and from pick.
You can take all these drills.
Once you start getting these little things, you're going to teach players to open their game. I wish I would know about it.
When people rush from that,
just to get the service.
Developing these kids has become one of my greatest passions. And I'm actually on my way now to go see one of the very first kids I ever started training.
Me and Marcos, we're like family too. Like me and his family, we go back. And their family is like Mariah's family. He stays with his grandparents and they're like really nice people. Just nice people. And we were able to work as a team when it comes to the development of the kid. And that's the most important part, is like, I don't want to just be, you know, a player development coach and then not have the participation of the parent. I think it makes things kind of weird, especially when there's certain things that need to be said to the kid. And if you don't have that relationship with them or with their family, you know, it's always going to be something. It's gonna be, you don't talk to my kid like that. But in reality, it's like some of these kids need to be held accountable. And if I can't do that, I can't do my job. Therefore, you don't need to hire me. Right? So it wasn't just, you know, you train my kid. No, like you're a part of my family now, you know, and we take care of each other and we're going to work together on stuff. And that's pretty much what it was. And that's pretty much how it's been with a lot of me and the other kids that I've trained that were consistent, not necessarily the other ones.
Marcos was a great first kid to have as a trainer because he worked hard and he loved basketball. It was such a great thing to see. Not only that, but he used to come on his birthdays, after practice, before practice, and just put the work in. Not only was he dedicated, but his family was dedicated. His grandma would try to get in the gym whenever she could. And if his grandpa was there, he was helping. If his brothers and sisters were there, they were helping. It was truly a family thing, and I enjoyed it so much. So much that it became a part of who I am as a trainer. Marcos got to stay with me and my brother for 2 days straight over the weekend. All we did was hoop, play video games, go back to the gym, and work out. He pulled 2-a-days on both of those days and put that real work in. I only say that to say, not a lot of parents would leave their kids with their coach or with their trainer, especially not over the weekend, just to play video games and play basketball. That's not a thing, but I think that speaks to the character of not only me, but my brother who is also a trainer, and it speaks to how much value and how much dedication we are willing to put within the kids that we work with. For someone to trust us enough to take care of their kid for a whole weekend, yeah, we're dedicated to this.
This man pulling up in a Camaro with the Lakers colors. That's crazy. Man, who do you think you are with the Lakers colors? That's a nice car.
Thank you.
Marcos has a similar story to Mariah. Although he was producing at the school that he was at, he wasn't getting the right amount of playing time that he felt he deserved. So instead of staying, he switched schools. Now, Marcos is a good player. More than anything, he's a shooter. That's what he does. He shoots the ball. He could shoot it since the very first day that I met him. And all we did was fine-tune a couple of things. But he still shoots the exact same way right now. I took him through a workout where we went over contact finishes, how to read the defender, how to make quick decisions. Not only that, but I took him through the workout and showed him some of the details that Drew Hanlon showed us at the player development conference.
Right? I'll tell you when to stop. Down, more.
Believe me, guys, nothing is ever as easy as it looks just because you saw one person do it.
Better. Right? So still go back, like when you put your back, hips back, go 1-2. Yeah. 1-2. Yep, right, now do it. Try to add in the 1-2. Down, back, in. Boom, boom. Right, again. Boom, boom. Bring that ball around. 1-2. 1-2. Better. Go again. 1-2. Better. One again. There you go. One more time. One more time. Good. Right, but you're all. There you go. Good. That's not bad. Right. Go again, one more time. Watch the wrap, watch the wrap, watch the wrap. Get a clean wrap around the leg first. Down, back, in. Down, back, in. Good. Good. So go between, carry out. Right? So look at your feet when you do it. So instead of having straight feet, you have staggered feet. So you go between and then go chest. 1-2. Between. Between, butt down. Butt down. There you go. Between. Between. There you go. Lift. Butt back. Butt back. Butt back. Boom, boom. There you go. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Easy. Alright, so we'll go between out. Oh. Between. Boom. There you go. Good. Try to hold it for longer. Between. Step. There you go. Better. So fast. Between. Float. Oh. Good. There you go. Good. Hold it.
It was so good being back in the gym with Marcos because we haven't trained together in almost 2 years. It's been a long time. So just getting those vibes back, that nostalgia back, really meant a lot to me. And the fact that he called me out of nowhere meant a lot more. The kid is still a bucket and knows how to play basketball.
Take the breath.
And that's one thing that I'm super proud of.
Oh, that's lucky. Free throw is like going to the ATM machine. You gotta cash in. Don't let you get the and one. I'm getting more money. I need more money. It's free money. Good. Marcos the baller. He's taller than me. That's crazy. Dude is taller. What the hezzy? Used to be in the gym all the time. I was talking to somebody and I was like, there's only like a couple kids that used to come like all the time, like consistently. And like actually work hard. And you was one of those kids.
Yeah.
But you was also like one of my first
kids that you trained.
Yeah, one of the first, like the very first.
Yep.
And they were like,
it was me and then that other dude that was at the Air Force. And then I was there.
I don't know.
And he had a girl.
Yeah, Mariah. I still got Mariah. But for the most part, like the other kids, they was just there. And they would come sometimes. But I only had like a couple people. He was one of those people. And now you tall. You out here boxing. What you say? What's the record? 2-0. And you gonna keep boxing? Or you gonna try to play? You gonna try to play in college? Or what you gonna do?
Golden Gloves.
Golden Gloves?
Yeah.
That's the goal?
Yeah.
So you gonna try to... Are you gonna keep playing basketball though?
Yeah.
Like after you graduate.
That's my main sport for right now. And then boxing is just there. Just if I don't get a scholarship or anything for basketball.
Dude, you can get a scholarship.
Huh?
You can get a scholarship.
Yeah. But see how it goes.
I can help you get a scholarship.
Okay.
Like for real. You just gotta do the right things.
Okay.
I got you.
All right, Jocelynn.
All right. See, I mess with this dude named Larry June. And he said you gotta stay consistent. Turn it up, Larry.
Don't call me the king of shit. I'm just trying to live. Take care of my son. Buy another Benz. Living on the edge, but it's all about decisions. The least you can do is put the